Welcome. Today's video is going to be on how to judge peppers. Well, we're going to be taking a look at just some general characteristics of peppers, and then take a look at some of the terms you're going to be using, and then give you an opportunity to go ahead and take those terms and also take a look at peppers to see what they're about, and for you to come up with your own set of reasons. So let's get started. When you are judging, there are some things you need to keep in mind. First of all, the maturity. Because peppers are, for the most part, you look at two things. You look at quality and you also look at condition. Those are the two things more than anything else. And maturity, for the most part, is pretty much the same in all the different grading classifications. Like, for instance, there's U.S. Fancy, U.S. Number 1, and U.S. Number 2. Another thing, it also takes a look at its shape. Now, there is a size requirement. They need to be 2.5 inches in diameter, no less than that, and no less than 2.5 inches in length as well. So shape is a really important characteristic you need to look for and judge. Also, cleanliness. Usually just use the word clean or fairly clean, but you never use the word slightly dirty, for instance. They're either dirty, they're fairly clean, or they're clean, either one of those three. Also, we look at a variety of different defects when it comes time for condition. When we're looking at quality, we're looking at things like sunburn or Sunscald. We're also looking for things such as insect damage or misshapen. And that misshapen part sometimes can actually cause them to lose a number grade. You can go from like U.S. U.S. Fancy to U.S. Number 1 if it's not shaped in that kind of bell kind of shape that we're used to in bell peppers. The other thing we look at now is condition. Freshness is also a very important. And when we look at freshness, we're looking at, well, fresh or not. If they're not fresh, then they're not in good condition. And then in terms of firmness, we're trying to look at this particular, and this is a fruit, by the way, it's the ovary that develops, but then we still call it a vegetable. Anyway, this particular fruit needs to be firm to the touch, where the walls of the ovary aren't breaking down. They're not shriveled, they're not crushed. And then the colors. Now remember, I said the colors need to be in, if it's a yellow pepper, it needs to be yellow, not at the point of turning color. As a matter of fact, it downgrades it if 15% or more of it isn't all the way colored. So when you're looking and judging for them, you're making sure that if it's yellow, it's all yellow. If it's red, it's all red. It's not slightly green with a streak of red in it. That obviously would be a no-no. And defects, as I've already mentioned, crushed, shriveled, broken, all of those kind of defects are the things that we're looking for when we're judging. So you're going to have 2 minutes to judge these samples. And so we're going to give you a visual inspection. You have 2 minutes starting right now. Go ahead. All right, you're 2 minutes up. Now it's time for us to do the critique. How'd you place it? Well, the way I placed it was plate one was first, plate two was second, plate four was third, and the last plate, plate number three, obviously was last. So let's get into it, and then let me give you a quick rundown as far as how I saw it. Well, today, in today's pepper class, I judged it in the order of 1, 2, 4, and 3. I put plate number 1 first primarily because it was well-shaped. It also was firm with very little, if any, blemishes that I could see. And there was no pitting. It was free from any kind of decay. We also see a very uniform in its size, shape, and color. I believe this one really represents what today's produce managers are trying to put out for the public. It's going to have a long shelf life. It's going to yield a lot of product for the consumer. I believe this is definitely the best in the class. I place plate number 2 in second place. I grant this particular class also was very fresh. It was firm to the touch. But I criticize and put it second because it has some pitting, and also it had a little bit of bruising on it as well. I just don't think it's going to do quite as well in the retailer showcase as is our previous plate, plate number 1. Let's go move on to plate number 4, which is in third place today. I placed plate 4 in third primarily because of some conditioning problems. First of all, I criticize it for being a little misshapen. I believe that it's probably going to drop down from a U.S. Fancy to a U.S. number 1 because of that slight misshapen. It also, on one of the peppers, also had some walls that were crushed a little bit. And I believe that that might lead to some soft rot or some loss of product to the consumer today. Just not as uniform in its appearance as also the previous two plates. And that's why I put plate number 4 in third place. And then in last place today, I believe it was really easy to tell that sample 3 had the least amount of condition. It was shriveled, it was crushed, it had discoloration, and even on the calyx also had some rot in it. I believe this one has little to no shelf life left and possibly could be a cull in terms of how the produce buyer and manager will deal with this. And that's why I put plate number 3 in fourth and final place today. Well, how'd you do? Really quickly, just to go over, it's 1, 2, 4, 3 with cuts of 2, 7, and 4. I really believe the first two plates really were really good in terms of its condition as well as its quality. Whereas the quality was all right in the last two, but the condition is the thing that suffered the most. And so would be the consumer in this particular case if all they had to choose from was plates 4 and 3. Well, as we wrap things up today, I just wanted to leave you with this quote of the day. If we don't discipline ourselves, the world will do it for us. Isn't that the truth? Even in this particular contest, if you're not disciplining, you're not practicing, somebody's going to take your opportunity. I hope you won't let that happen. Well, this wraps up another video on judging, on vegetable judging. If you would like to see more of these, please comment down below and let me know what kind of things you would like to see as far as with this ID, whether it's judging or something else. Just let me know. But in the meantime, put a headlock on that subscribe button and, of course, give a high five to the like button. So if you want to see any more of those, just let me know. And, oh, by the way, in less than a month, I will be seeing you at Arbuckle at the next contest. So, as I've said before, we'll see you at the next one. Thanks. Bye.